Welcome back to a tutorial on circuit theory, and well, in this video I'm going to discuss about the high pass filter. Okay, we're going to discuss today about the high pass RC first order filter. Okay, so there you go. All right, so in this video basically I'm going to show you how the high pass filter works, but before that I'm going to show the circuit over here. Okay, there you go. So here we have the circuit of the first order RC high pass filter. Okay, so okay, let's just name these as well, terminals 1 and terminals 2. So what we're gonna do over here is that we're gonna basically apply an input signal known as VI across the terminals 1 and 2 of this particular circuit. And of course, the output of this circuit would be obtained across that of this resistor R. So here we're going to have the output signal VO. Okay, so it's to be noted that, well, this input signal that we are applying over here is basically an AC input signal. Okay, so due to the application of this AC input signal over here, we're going to get this output as AC also across that of the resistor. And now we know that, well, here we have a capacitor which would offer a certain amount of reactance to an AC signal, as we've already studied before. So over here, the reactance of the capacitor obviously is given by, well, come on, let's just write it down over here as XC equals to 1 by J omega C, okay? Where, of course, well, C is the capacitance of the capacitor that we've used over here, and omega is, of course, 2 pi f. Well, it's known as the angular frequency of the applied input signal. Okay, and now we not only have the capacitor over here, we have the capacitor as well as the resistor. So this circuit is obviously going to offer some amount of impedance to the applied input signal, that's VI. Okay, so the impedance of this circuit is obviously given by R plus 1 by J omega C. Okay, so we've just wrote down over here. Okay, so here let's just take J in the numerator, then this expression would change a bit. We'll get R minus J divided by omega C. Okay, so here's what we have as the net impedance of this particular circuit. Okay, so let's just pull the page down a bit. Okay, that's better. So I have some writing space over here. So right now we're gonna find since we can see over here that the impedance is obviously a complex quantity. Okay, now we cannot perform mathematical operations that involve numbers with complex quantities, just gets too much above the head. So let's not just complicate matters in order to study what happens inside the circuit. And we're basically trying to find the transfer function, which will obviously determine the circuit behavior. And in order to do that, we're basically need to find the modulus of this complex number, that's Z over here, that denotes the impedance of this circuit. So here we go, we gotta find out the modulus. So we're gonna get root over that of R square plus 1 by omega square C square. So there you go, that's the modulus of this particular term, that's the impedance of this circuit. Okay, and now if we go forward and try and find out how much of an output signal we're getting with respect to that of the input signal applied. Okay, that's basically we're trying to find out the gain of this particular circuit. So if we do that, then we need to obviously find the current through the circuit first. So there would be a certain finite amount of current, which would also be AC quantity that will keep on varying in polarity due to the applied input signal, which is also an AC. So due to that, we're going to find the current, that's the AC current that we're getting over here as well. We're going to get it as the input voltage divided by the entire impedance of the circuit. So we're going to get as VI divided by that of modulus Z. Okay, so it's going to be VI divided by root over that of R square plus 1 by omega square C squared. There you go. So now if we we are interested to find out the magnitude of this output voltage that we're going to basically, you know, obtain across that of the resistance R. Okay, so in order to do that, we need to basically find the output voltage that occurs across the resistor over here, as you can see. So in order to do that, we're basically gonna multiply the current that's basically flowing in the circuit, and it's also flowing through R, and now we need to multiply the resistance with the current in the circuit. So that's exactly what we're doing over here. So we're gonna get, well, VI over here, well, multiplied with R. And of course, in the denominator also, there we go, we just put in our necessary data over here. Okay, so there we go. So this is obviously the expression for our output voltage that we're going to obtain in case of a high pass filter. Well, and now in order to get the transfer function, which would obviously help in determining the behavior of this high pass filter, in order to do that, we of course, well, need to modify this equation a bit. Okay, so before we do that, let me just tell you, now this particular filter which we are discussing and we have discussed so far over here, well, you'll probably be wondering as to why this filter is called a high pass filter. It's because whenever we, since we have applied an AC input signal over here, okay, so what the filter basically does, I mean the filter circuit over here basically does is that it just lets pass, well, frequencies, I mean certain frequencies, okay, above its cutoff frequencies, as you'll have seen that in case of a low pass filter, well, given by FC equals to 1 by 2 pi, RC. So this determines, I mean this expression over here, well, determines the cutoff frequency of this RC high pass circuit, okay. So now, what the circuit will basically do is that it'll obviously allow the frequencies higher than the cutoff frequency to be outputted over here as the output signal, okay? But when the frequency just falls below that of the cutoff frequency of any applied input signal, then it'll obviously attenuate the same, and well, we cannot obtain it at the output, okay? Its magnitude will obviously, you know, go on diminishing. I mean, the output voltage magnitude will go on diminishing if we just, you know, decrease the frequency of this input AC signal voltage, okay? So let's go back to our mathematics again, and now if we just try and find out the gain of this particular circuit, then we're gonna get, well, the gain AV is equals to, well, that's the output voltage divided by the input voltage. We're basically gonna transfer VI right over here, that down below that of VO, so that way we'll get, well, R divided by root over of R square plus 1 by omega square C square. So we can go forward and plot a graph of, well, gain versus frequency, so that we can get the the characteristics of this particular circuit. Okay, so if we are trying to get the transfer function, we'll need to modify this equation a little bit. So if we just take R common from the denominator, then we're basically gonna get, well, R over here, so that just makes it 1, and we're gonna get, well, omega square R square and C square, and now we can just cancel R both on the top and the bottom, and if we just put forward the value of omega as 2 pi f, okay, then we're gonna get, well, 1 divided by that's 2 pi f RC, so that's whole squared, and if we just, you know, take this part out over here, if we're gonna get, well, if we're just gonna put together 2 pi RC together, and well, keep F alongside, okay, and this whole thing squared, so we know that over here, well, 2 pi RC gives us the cutoff frequency, that's FC. So if we go forward and, well, put this 1 by, if we just write down over here something like this, well, 1 divided by root over 1 plus 1 by 2 pi RC, okay, and then that's multiplied by F squared, then we are basically going to get this term as, well, the FC squared. So that way we can basically obtain the gain as equals to, well, 1 divided by root over 1 plus, well, FC divided by F squared. Okay, so these two are whole squared. So this is exactly the transfer function which we were searching for. So this particular thing is known as the, well, the transfer function of the circuit. Okay, so there you go. So with this transfer function, if we just go forward and, well, plot a graph between the frequency over here, as you can see, well, this particular frequency, that's f right over here, is of course variable, whereas the fc, that's the cutoff frequency for a circuit, is particularly constant. We know that fc is given by 1 by 2 pi rc. So if we are designing a circuit, let's say for example, if we design this particular circuit with a particular value of the capacitor and a particular value for the resistor, then for a particular given circuit, okay, we are going to have a fixed value of the cutoff frequency. So this particular term remains, well, fixed in case of a particular first order RC filter. While this F that we have at the bottom over here, so this particular term, of course, represents the variable frequency of the applied input signal. So I'll just write it down over here. So this is, of course, the, well, the frequency. Okay, there you go. Frequency of the applied input signal. Okay. So there you go, applied input signal. Okay. So that way we are going to basically, if we just go forward and, well, let's just, you know, set up an experiment where we can, well, basically construct the circuit for a definite value of R and C and then go on increasing the frequency. If we just do that experiment, then we're going to basically obtain a characteristics which would look something like this, as you can see over here. So here, this particular well, figure represents the characteristics which we are supposed to obtain in case of this particular circuit. So if you take a look at this expression for the transfer function, once again, then you'll see that once we you know, go on decreasing this value of f over here, so I'll write it down over here. So if you go on, well, decreasing the value of f, if f down below tends towards zero, then in that case, this particular term, that's fc divided by f whole square, this particular term would tend towards infinity. Okay, and now since this particular term tends towards infinity, the whole of the denominator would become infinite for this particular expression for the gain. Okay, and that way the gain would obviously tend to in that case, the gain would, of the circuit would obviously, you know, tend towards zero, because anything divided by infinity is always zero. And on the other hand, if you just go on increasing this particular function, or I mean this frequency over here, so if f tends to infinity, on the other hand, then in that case, well, this fc by f term would become zero. Okay, this term would tend towards zero. So that way, well, we'll have the gain, you know, tending towards one. So in that case, the gain of the circuit over here from the transfer function would tend towards 1. So in that case, if the gain is 1, we mean that, well, the output signal is obviously 100% equal to that of the input signal. So there is no loss at all. So if we are just going to put, I mean, use this philosophy over here and, well, implement a circuit this way, then we can obviously get a characteristic curve that would resemble something like this. So here we have, as predicted from the expression for the transfer characteristics, we're going to get a curve that would look something like this. So as you can see over here, well, this is the gain that we have plotted. Okay, so I'll just use a different color over here. Okay, that's better. So this is obviously the gain AV plotted over here. Okay, and this is of course the frequency for this particular characteristics. Okay, and over here you can see, well, the cutoff frequency, demarcated by, well, the symbol FC, as you can see over here, that's the dotted line. Okay, there you go. So at this particular value of the frequency, that's the FC, that's the cutoff frequency over here, the signal gain, okay, if I just write down over here, well, if f is equals to FC, then from the transfer function we're going to get, well, AV would be equals to 1 by root 2. So which means that the gain for the circuit would of course fall to, well, about 0.707th part of its maximum value. So here we have the gain. So you can see over here the maximum gain would be 1, where obviously, you know, the input signal is equal to the output signal. So you can see that the circuit approaches this gain equals to 1 once it's way above FC, that you can see over here. Once the the frequency is way above the cutoff frequency, the characteristics, the gain, okay, approaches 1. And on the other hand, if the frequency is below that of the cutoff frequency, as you can see over here, if you just go towards this 0 point over here, towards the left side of this x-axis, then we can see over here that the gain decreases until it becomes 0. So as I said, and now at this point, at the cutoff frequency, as you can see over here, at this particular point, the gain drops down to about 0.707 part of its maximum value. So here at this particular point, I'll just use a different color, okay, so let's just use blue. So at this particular point, the gain has fallen to its, gain by root 2. It's 0.707 value right over here. So now this particular point is also known as, the 3 decibel gain. Okay, so this point, the gain that we have over here is also known as the 3 decibel gain. Okay, so I'll just write it down over here. There you go. So now at this, now you'll probably be asking as why this point is known as the 3 decibel gain. I mean, why this gain is known as 3 decibels? Okay, it's because if we are going to plot this 0.707 in decibels, so in decibels, if we're going to plot the gain, then we're going to get about 20 log 10 0.707. If we're going to just plot this particular value of the gain in decibels, then we're going to get, about something like minus 3.01. Okay, so we're going to get something like this. So this particular, that's the gain we're going to have over here, will be minus 3 decibels. And now if we just take the difference from the maximum value of the gain, then we're going to get a difference of 3 decibels as well, which is of course shown over here. Okay, so to sum up, we can basically say that, the high pass filter here that we have shown is of the first order. And if we go on increasing the orders as well, that's the second and third orders, then we can see that, the characteristic would become even more steeper. Okay, so that's it from this tutorial video. So see you in the next one. Until then, it's a short goodbye for now, and thanks for watching.